So how do you get from this, to this, to this? It's not a quantum physics question about Euclidean geometry and the transformation of conscious particle matter amalgamating into post-symbiotic edible fast food. No, no, no. It's about buying and eating fast food and making a cheaper imitation. You all know how the ad goes for one of the most classic iconic burgers of all time. Two all-beef patties, special sauce, lettuce, cheese, pickles, onions on a sesame seed bun. If you don't, then clearly there is a generational gap or you live in a country that doesn't do McDonald's. I'm Chris and welcome to Fast Food Fight, the show where I review popular dishes from fast food chains and recreate them to look and taste like their retail products whilst reducing the cost. So today I'm shopping at Woolworths and of course, McDonald's. Doesn't your heart skip a beat when you think of getting two all-beef patties? Special sauce, lettuce, cheese, pickles, onion, on a sesame seed bun. Well, for $5.85, it better be really special sauce. Dunno guys, tell me what you think. Is it just me, or have these things got smaller with time? I mean, everything's there. It's just like the ad. Tastes delicious, as always. But they just seem to have gotten smaller with time. Don't know why. Maybe people are a bit more health conscious. Personally, when I think of the Big Mac, I think of the ad where they all say the jingle in all those different languages. Goes to show how effective advertising is. So many years ago and I can still quote it verbatim. Tell me your thoughts in the comments section below. And while you're there, don't forget to subscribe. Ding-a-ling-a-ling. So this burger is everything that you would come to expect from a McDonald's burger. I'm here to just replicate the look and the taste. So let's get cracking. Wax paper down on a flat surface. Salt and white pepper. Roll out your beef patties to be 11 centimeters, which is 1 centimeter bigger than the buns. The thing to remember is that your patties will shrink. Next, whack them on your grill. I'm using an old George Foreman grill so that the oil runs out. Use whatever you feel like. The next thing you want to do is cut the bun just above and below that seam. Now if you stuff it up, it's going to end up looking like this. And your end result's going to end up looking like this. So the other way is to use two buns. And for this center toasty bit, use a second bun here. The great part of having a George Foreman grill is that you can use the fat runoff to toast your buns. Alternatively, you can use the grill. Up to you. Next, chop an onion. About half is all you're going to need. Then whack an iceberg. So now it's time to make your special sauce. I'm going low tech today. In other words, I'm using a cup. Start by adding a bit of onion to your cup. Next, you want to add a tablespoon of sweet pickle relish. French salad dressing, 2 tablespoons of mayonnaise. Next, you want to add a teaspoon of vinegar, a teaspoon of pepper, and a teaspoon of salt. Here's a hint, if you don't have any French salad dressing, just use some garlic powder, some paprika, and maybe add a little bit of cornstarch if it doesn't thicken up for you. Now it's time to add your special sauce to the heel of the bun. Next you want to add some cheese, some lettuce, a patty, a little toasty bit, some more sauce, some more lettuce, some more cheese, another patty, a little bit of gherkins and onions and stuff on the top, you know the drill. 2 all beef patties, special sauce, lettuce, cheese, pickles, onions on a sesame seed bun. And you can get all this accomplished for a tad under $3. So go on, give it a go. I bet you can't screw it up as badly as I did. Anyway, this has been Chris from Moddy Munch, and I'll see you next time. Special sauce.